NFL pennant and an undefeated regular season. Now the Trojans have their sights set on an NCS pennant. It's the quarterfinals of NCS soccer, a rematch between El Cerrito and Petaluma. Next.
Another wonder goal! Oh my goodness!
And a very good evening from Steve Ellison Field. I'm Griffin Epstein. We have a great scene here from this Saturday night in Petaluma. It is the NCS quarterfinals as the El Cerrito Gauchos make the trip from the East Bay to take on the Trojans in a rematch between these two teams. They played all the way back in December. Petaluma pulled out a 3-2 comeback. Thrilling win. We expect another great game tonight as the Trojan team that has not lost a game all season tries to win an NCS pennant for the first time in program history. It will start tonight here in the quarterfinals of NCS.
As we welcome you up top, Steve Ellison Field, you can see El Cerrito on the white, Petaluma in the black jacket shaking hands after a very lengthy pregame ceremony to celebrate the NCS festivities. Only the third, it's the third game in the last 3 years of NCS played here at Steve Ellison Field, showing the success of Petaluma girls soccer, but it is the first quarterfinals game. Petaluma as the number two seed in NCS, coming off a bye in the first round. El Cerrito, the number seven seed in NCS, defeated San Rafael 2-1 in the East Bay. That is how we've gotten here. The winner of this game will face Campolindo, the number three seed in the next round. Campolindo, the Cougars, have just finished off Akalani's in their game in Lafayette. A lot of pressure, a lot of nerves, but these teams know each other well, as we mentioned, and what a classic it was. One of the hardest the Trojans have been challenged all year in a season that they have not lost a game. Petaluma was trailing by 1:10 minutes remaining in El Cerrito all the way back on December 12th, a Wednesday night, and the Trojans scored two goals in the last 10 minutes to win the game. That was the difference for Petaluma to win that game against the Gauchos. The Gauchos have some talented strikers. They are young at first glance, but in fact actually very experienced overall in terms of returners. 11 returners from a team last year that also went to the quarterfinals of NCS, as did Petaluma, and the Trojans themselves, 14 returners on a team that lost 1-0 to Kennedy in Fremont last year in the NCS quarterfinals. This time a remarkable year. They're 15-0-3. They get a home game against El Cerrito and a chance to go to the NCS semifinals for the first time this decade. And a team that's number two in NCS, they absolutely, realistically have a shot at an NCS pennant. That starts tonight. And Petaluma will hope with three more victories they can raise an NCS pennant for the first time in program history. But against the Gauchos, it's going to be an awful big challenge. The Trojans break huddle. They've had a lot of time to prep for this. 10 days since their last game. It was a VVAL clinchers. Petaluma defeated American Canyon 3-0 to win the VVAL pennant, their first league pennant outright since 2009. The Gauchos have had an outstanding season this year as well, playing in a better league than Petaluma in the TCAL Stone League. The Gauchos finished second at 9-0-3, 12-4-3 overall, and their most impressive victory of the season, a victory over Campolindo, the team that the winner of this game will face Campolindo in the next round. El Cerrito has also played Miramonte this year, the number one seed in NCS, who is also playing tonight. Healthy crowd out here for Steve Ellison Field. The stands are really starting to fill up. The energy is evident on the Petaluma side. It's more solemn and focused on the El Cerrito side. They've already played a game. They are ready, and most of their players were already up at Sonoma County last year. They fell to Annalee 2-0 in the quarterfinals. The tension already palpable. Trojans with nine seniors. The pressure is on not to make this their last. El Cerrito trying to get to the NCS semifinals. Both growing programs here in NCS Division III. Trojans in purple with the white piping. El Cerrito in white with the green piping. The Trojans are 2-0-1 against Gauchos this year. A victory over Casa clinched them the VVAL title at Casa Grande, a 2-1 victory 2 weeks ago. Trojans are down two women, though, for this game. One of the Trojans' best players, Melissa Rocha, leads them in assists, third in goals, out likely for the rest of the year with a knee contusion she suffered in a practice 2 weeks ago. Nonetheless, Trojans haven't missed a beat without her. Same with Athena Edwards, who got a concussion in the Trojans' senior night victory over Napa. She is confirmed out for the rest of the year, NCS playoffs, and potentially into state. Trojans have already played with both without them. 2-0 victory over Sonoma Valley 2 weeks ago, 3-0 victory over American Cannon in their VVL clincher game. We're underway here from Steve Ellison Field, 80 minutes to decide things and send a victor on to the NCS semifinals. This Trojan team has been excellent defensively all year long, but the difference from last year to this year has been the offense for Petaluma. Shut out in the NCS quarterfinals last year, this team believes that will not happen this year. Trojans average 3.3 goals per match, have 59 goals on the season. And the Trojans will be looking to Francis Gogenauer and Lauren Hazel, who lead the Trojans in goals scored with 11. Turnover on the back here early, pass a little bit too far. And the Gauchos applying some pressure here on the back end for Petaluma and their experienced defense. All 3-year-plus varsity players on the back end for Petaluma, and Zoe Frothinger, Sarah Muganum, Tessa Lambert, and Amanda Rocha. The Trojans trust them, and they also trust their goalkeeper, Silvana Sessi, who's had an outstanding year as only a freshman, including some brilliant performances against some good teams. Didn't have to do a lot of work when these teams played before, only made 4 saves. Gauchos got just 6 shots off in that game, but they did score twice and nearly pulled off the upset over the Trojans. Gauchos control play early here, 2.5 minutes gone, or 1.5 minutes gone, I should say. Off in a slow start to high school soccer game, wouldn't be surprised if we see a little rust from the purple and white to start. It's been a long time off, long time getting ready for this, and means things have to be amped up. All the pressure and the nerves have to be put into this, and once Petaluma gets about 10 minutes into this game, you expect and hope, if you're a Trojan fan, that goes away. The Gauchos have already been able to get those out with a 2-1 victory over 10th-seeded San Rafael on Wednesday. Gaucho goes down hard there, but no contact, I thought was the ruling, but now the ref coming over to with a few words, but no foul. Hope for some good reffing tonight. These refs, as it was eulogized in the long pregame ceremony, are selected for their outstanding performance. We've seen some bad reffing this year. The Gauchos send it in dangerously. Muganum with a good header and a nice big boot. Rocha got a foot on that just to get that out of danger, and sometimes that's what you got to do. The Gauchos have a couple prolific scores to look to. Two, in fact, and they really run their offense through two players. It is Rihanna Burton, 15 goals for the Gauchos this year, and Elisa Chin, both juniors. She has 16 goals this year. The next Gaucho is well after that with only 2 goals on the year. So if the Trojans can find a way to shut down Chin and Burton, they are going to be very much helped with their defense, and there aren't a lot of options for the Gauchos. As much as this team is talented, they're very one-dimensional. Trojans, that's not the case. Petaluma has not won a game in almost a month. They have been dominant. Their last draw, they had 3 draws on the year, was January 19th to one of the best teams in the state, top 20th in the state, Marin Academy. They tied 1-1. Petaluma has proved they can play with anyone, and they have a winning knack. But so far, they need to get some offense going. Looking for Hazel, down the flank. Hazel takes it away. Tough angle for the Trojan. But the crowd here, which has very impressively filled up. This is by far the largest crowd of any Petaluma girls soccer game this year. Giving the approval to the Trojans and their first look at any offensive chances. We match it. Gogenhauer and Hazel have to be in the middle of everything for this Trojan offense, especially without Melissa Rocha. But Petaluma's had to learn to live without her, including in their most impressive victory of the year against Casa Grande. The Trojans had two goals in that one. Of course, those two goals were by Athena Edwards, who also isn't playing tonight. Hazel had a goal last time out for Petaluma against American Cannon, and she also scored when these teams played El Cerrito as well. Kendra Berry had a good game in that one as well for Petaluma. A goal and an assist for her. Alondra Hernandez-Ramirez, nice steal. She's looking for Herman forward, but the Trojans' long balls are not online just yet. Now Burton the other way. We mentioned how dangerous this junior is. She has an electric foot and can put it anywhere in the net and can make it very hard for Ceci. Lambert's just going to poke this one out, but nice job to get it deflected off the Gaucho. Petaluma ball. Slow start to this one. 5.5 minutes gone. No score from Steve Ellison Field on this Saturday night quarterfinals of NCS. El Cerrito has also not advanced to the NCS semifinals, and the records that date back that I could find. But they have had a successful program the last couple years. So this is going to be their third straight year of a winning record under longtime head coach Antonio Pigali. His seventh year now. A boot forward. This is Crisdale, the talented sophomore. Trojans of excellent speed. Crisdale, the cross, it gets through, loose, cleared away. Somehow that one got by the Gaucho keeper, and it was nearly put away by Hazel. A horrible defensive mistake by the Gaucho keeper, who is absolutely a weakness to pinpoint if you are the Trojans. Christina Martinez has allowed 21 goals this year in 19 games, and she gives up. She's only had two shutouts all year. She's going to give up goals. This one's set in. The header unable to be firmly connected in. It's going to be Gaucho ball. But not a bad look at all by Amanda Rocha. Melissa might not be out there, but the very talented twin sister is. Rocha doesn't have a goal on the year, but a good look there. And the Trojans starting to apply some pressure, some good looks. This back end for El Cerrito is the most shakiest part of their team. Christina Martinez gives up nearly 1.25 goals per game. And they haven't even totally relied on her because they haven't trusted her. The Trojans saw Odalis Davalos, her backup for the first 40 minutes. When these teams played back in December, they benched Davalos and brought out Martinez, who promptly gave up two goals. The Trojans can get quality shots on net. Martinez is not the most apt at saving them. And with Gogenhauer and Hazel out there, those are the most two clinical finishers for Petaluma. The Trojans' chemistry has been excellent this year, been able to piece things together and get everything just right. I think the hardest thing for them, they've not played as good teams in the VVAL, and they kind of just naturally had possession. The challenge in these NCS games is they're not going to be automatically given possession. They are not automatically the faster team, the more physical team, the more talented team. They're going to have to fight tooth and nail just to get possession, to get those opportunities. And that includes against the Gauchos here tonight. Beautiful ball from Hazel to her friend Barry. Tried the give and go, but the Gauchos all over it. Lauren Hazel is playing electric so far tonight. She is scampering all over the field and making life difficult early for these Gaucho defenders. 11 goals this year to the junior midfielder's name, and we mentioned her outstanding performance against El Cerrito last time. She likes playing against any type of Gauchos, but especially the El Cerrito ones, unlike the crosstown rival Casa Grande Gauchos, who are playing in NCS tonight. Dangerous pass. The Gauchos get it out. You can see they're good with their footwork. This is a confident team, and they're going to be cool under pressure. Frothinger to Crisdale. And back to the junior co-captain. The Trojans pressing up.
Rocha to Hazel, and the Trojans now, they've got possession. Now can they get into their offense? Lauren Hazel making mad mess on that one. Dangerous probing pass, deflected out. Burton now hoping to head the other way, and El Cerrito can get out on the break here. The Trojans, after a first couple slow minutes, are finding their possession, they're finding their footwork, and Lauren Hazel is feeling good tonight so far. Rocha coming up. She's got some room down the flank. All the way across, and Hazel falls to the ground. No call. The refs have kept the whistles in the pocket so far tonight. Gauchos with a steal. And the first shot on goal is an easy save for Martinez. But nervy goalkeeper, big game. Not a bad idea by one of the most accomplished seniors in Gauchos, who's the most clinical finisher on Petaluma and has made her wonder goals famous around the Petaluma campus. Burton with the steal. The Trojans need to slow Burn down. She is a danger. See three Trojans surrounding her. Frothinger was able to get a piece of it, and Lambert, the best Petaluma defender, able to clear it away. Lambert will be headed to college to play soccer next year. Four-year varsity player, and all the work that all these Trojans have done have built up for a moment like this. A chance to go to the NCS semifinals farther than Trojan soccer has gone in recent memory. A chance to win an NCS pennant. Already accomplished so much, but so much more on the line tonight. For a team that hasn't lost, you have to have great hope. 12 minutes gone here in the first half. Of 40, no score, nil-nil, one shot on goal, it was Petaluma. Already seen back and forth in terms of momentum here, both teams playing with a lot of energy. There's no doubt both teams want this game. I think for the Gauchos, the struggle is gonna be to get shots on goal with this defense. They did score two goals against Petaluma, but they only had six shots in that game back in December. This is a Trojan defense that likes to not have to make Savannah Sessi work. We've had games where Sessi could have probably piped out half of her English 9 homework if she wanted. And the Trojans have been great at protecting her. Not in all games, though. Against Marin Academy, we mentioned that, the most impressive result of the Trojan season, she came up with 15 saves. So she's all the more capable, too. But it means you need to get shots on the talented freshman keeper for Petaluma. That's a very risky pass. One mistake on the back end, and you could suddenly be down 1-0 in the strike of lightning. Gauchos battling in the middle of the field. Nice job. These Gauchos are physical. Mentioning Sessi in her 18 games this year, just 8 goals allowed, has made 89 saves over the course of the year, and she allows less than half a goal per game. 10 shutouts to her name. Sessi has been fantastic as a freshman keeper, and what was really, I think, the Achilles heel for Petaluma coming into the year, they didn't have a goalkeeper, didn't know who it was going to be after Clara Garcia, the keeper last year for Petaluma, headed back to Spain. Trojans found Sessi, and it has worked out. Herman battling, and see both teams, I think, being pretty physical. A lot of refs would call a lot of this fouls, but they've quickly understood how this game's gonna be called. It's gonna be called loosely, and they're gonna let the players play. And you can admire that from the refs, and they're being consistent, and they're telling the players you can be physical and aggressive. And as long as no one gets hurt, you have to be satisfied with that in a playoff game. Playoff games, seasons on the line, pennants on the line, legacies, players' careers. That shouldn't be decided by fouls. Rocha. That's intercepted, and Trojans need to build it up from the back a little bit better. Gave themselves a couple chances, but it's been slow going for this Petaluma offense early. Obviously a long, long ways off, 65 more minutes in fact, but NCS playoffs do have overtime. No golden goal in overtime. They would play 2 15-minute periods, and if it was still tied, we would head to PKs. First foul of the game is called on Petaluma. The Gauchos will get a free kick.
Gauchos 44 goals on the season, 2.2 goals per match. They know how to score, mostly through Burton and Chin. Only four seniors on El Cerrito, but with 11 returners from an even younger team last year, they've got plenty of experience and poise, as they've shown with some very good victories this year, playing in a very tough schedule, playing a lot of the top programs in the East Bay. Stolen away, Crisdale. Gogenhauer, she can score from there, she fires! Save is made, as that one was going to spiral wide anyways, but Gogenhauer, anywhere inside that 30-yard line, can put one in the back of the net. You have to be careful and close quick. The Gauchos did a good job not letting Gogenhauer have much room. We've seen a bunch of teams make mistakes this year on that, to the tune of 11 goals for the senior. Martinez, the sophomore, comes out to take it. Only a sophomore goalkeeper. She was the keeper for the Gauchos last year as well, so she does have some NCS experience. Gogenhauer, one-on-one here with the defender. She might have been better off another opportunity, but the Gauchos have been making a plethora of mistakes on the back end with their defense and just not being smart in this game. And they just cannot afford that against some of the talent firepower in this Petaluma offense. They're going to make Martinez have a much harder night than she should. Frothinger. Herman with lots of space to work with and friends jogging down the field. Crisdale's been active early. Sophomore, but another returner for Petaluma on two-thirds of the team that was played in NCS last year. Hazel fires, deflects, it scores! Lauren Hazel has scored! It's Lauren Hazel's birthday, and now she's got a birthday gift to boot. 1-0 Petaluma as the Trojans strike first blood here in the NCS playoffs in the 18th minute. Hazel has made it 1-0. Talked about the weakness in goal for the Gauchos. Trojans did a nice job building that up. Herman had some room down the flank, was patient, found one of the best Trojan scores right in the middle of the field. She put some extra mustard on it. Martinez couldn't handle it, and certainly one you want saved if you're El Cerrito, but credit to Hazel for an exceptional shot and making that awfully difficult, and Petaluma knows the Gaucho keepers aren't the best and challenge them, and Lauren Hazel continues her tear of late. The junior has been remarkable for Petaluma, now 12 goals on the season. She led them in scoring last year as a sophomore. She probably will again next year as a senior. And for all the seniors that will be leaving this year for Petaluma 9, in fact, there's plenty of hope with these young players. Foul on the Gauchos on the far side. So now that the Trojans have scored, how will El Cerrito respond? They did very well when these teams last played in December, so much that they took a 2-1 lead. The Trojans' offense that occasionally this year has gone MIA, so far an excellent start. Gauchos, as we mentioned, though, have all the firepower to score, but they don't like to share the ball. They're not a team that develops. They really rely on Burden and Chin to do a lot of their work. The Trojans can force the Gauchos to slow down. It's going to be hard for them. The Gauchos have only on about half of their goals have assists on them. 44 goals scored, 35 assists. Danger here, high flying ball. Hazel fell to the turf. This is a slick turf. There was plenty of rain last night. I was here, in fact, for some lacrosse, and it was pouring at times, and it's been really a deluge after deluge for the last week, and unfortunately, Hazel found the turf monster there. That can be your best defense sometimes. 1-0, the Trojans lead as we approach the halfway point of this first half. If Petaluma wins tonight, they'll be right back here at Steve Ellison Field on Wednesday night in the semifinals to face
Campolindo, the defending NCS Division III champion. What a game that could be, but the Trojans have to focus on this one against the Gauchos first. We've also seen a Petaluma team that hasn't cost them, but they've let some teams back into games, notably a 2-1 win over Vintage. They were cruising along. Vintage nearly tied up that game, which would have been disaster for Petaluma's VVAL hopes. The Trojans need to make sure to keep their focus, even if they add more. Petaluma team that averages 3 goals, though, per game. That is a little bit inflated by some high-scoring ones against inferior opponents, but the Trojans, even against strong teams, have shown a knack to score and so far done that tonight. Deegan Babala in his third year for Petaluma, 41-14-6 overall. He's 2-2 in NCS, and both the last 2 years has lost in this round in the NCS quarterfinals. 2 years ago, Trojans were blown out by County Powerhouse Montgomery. And then last year, the 1-0 loss to Kennedy of Fremont. Barry, not a good forward. Danger as Crisdale was on the end of that one, but a nice play by Martinez to get it out. And the Trojans have to be benefiting from this electric atmosphere. This is a lot of fun right now. It's a good 300 fans, I would say, in these purple stands on the home side, and they are making a lot of noise tonight. The Trojans have had the unlucky fortune of playing almost all their games at the same time as the boys' basketball team, and it's lacked a lot of students coming out to a lot of games. A lot of rain as well has been a disincentive, but with a lot of rain over the last week, but clear skies tonight, and an NCS quarterfinal game, Trojan fans and a plethora of students as well, numbering about 30, have made their way out. Burton with the steal, very dangerous. You got to get the ball out of her feet. Nice job by Mugana. She's running over players. At deflects, you could see the talent of Brianna Burton. 15 goals, 5 assists, and averaging over a goal a game. And you can see why. She ran through this Trojan defense for what a goal to help beat, to help at least make that game against the Trojans very competitive last time. Put a scare in Petaluma. She is dangerous with a capital D. Hazel, what a game she's had so far. Goal to her name. Trojans done an excellent job controlling the ball in the middle third as that ball slowly rolled to make things interesting. Eleanor Burnett was chasing after it, but Martinez able to get to it. One save, one goal allowed for the Gaucho keeper. She's been shaky at best. Trojan ball on the far side. After El Cerrito controlled possession for the first 5 minutes, it has been all Petaluma. Trojans have done an excellent job being patient, controlling the ball in the middle of third, and when the Gauchos have won it, Petaluma has been very aggressive. Quick double teams. They haven't let El Cerrito get any traction, and you can tell that Trojans have prepped for this. Hazel's cross deflected. Nice defense by the Gaucho there to help out Martinez, as it was Bader, the junior midfielder, was just able to get a piece of that and not let a dangerous ball into the box. Gogenhauer, Rocha. Forward to Hazel. And Petaluma trying to get those crosses downfield. We're always trying that for Rocha, the speediest player on Petaluma, but now looking for Burnett, Herman. Trojans haven't quite pieced it together with the runs just yet, but I think their slow development of tick-tock passing that the Spain men's national team popularized is very effective, and that's how the Trojans scored their first goal. And really create a headache for the defense. Put your head on a swivel. deflects out, and the Gauchos just forced to clear right now under duress from this Petaluma offense. Gauchos average 1.2 goals allowed per game. They have two shutouts on the year, and they're not going to have one tonight. The Trojans looking for more here as we reach the latter stages of this first half. 15 minutes to go, and the Gauchos' really only chance right now is the counterattack. Sessie hasn't been tested, and she's had to be pretty bored the last 10 minutes. Trojan offense is controlled. Looking, Hazel all alone. Hazel fires, save made. That time, though, the excellent ball, the connection. Hazel maybe was just a little bit too far wide. It put her in a very tight window to score and turned out being relatively easy for Martinez. Nice win. Gogenhauer streaking down the field. Now she's got players in the box. And Petaluma will get a corner. Gogenhauer is going to go take the corner. Nice move by her. Trojans' third corner of the game. They nearly scored off one. Mention NCS quarterfinals. Other games going on tonight. Marimonte, the number one seed, taking on Drake. And the four seed, Annalie, who the Trojans, I think, would love to face in the finals, considering their history. They are playing Alhambra. That's the 4-5 matchup. Sent in dangerous. Gogenhauer gets a take two here. The nice fake. And awkwardly deflects all the way through and out. Frothinger runs it down. She knocked over the flagpole, and unfortunately that is out of bounds. That Annalie-Alhambra game at Sebastopol. The winner of the Annalie-Alhambra game and the Marimonte-Drake game will play each other. The winner of that on to the NCS championship game. That will be next Saturday at a neutral site field. Evening, 7 o'clock, as will a potential semifinal game on Wednesday here at Steve Ellison Field if the Trojans win. Petaluma has never won an NCS pennant in girls lacrosse. They had girls soccer, I'm sorry. And have not been to the semifinals this decade in Trojan soccer. Back-to-back years losing in the quarterfinals, but everyone knew coming into this year the talent on this team, but no one expected them to be this good. Win a VVL pennant maybe, but finish the regular season without a loss, unparalleled in Petaluma history. And they have become the talk of the community. And it shows with the fans out tonight. 12 minutes remaining here in the biggest game in Petaluma girls soccer history. 1-0 the Trojans lead, and Petaluma has been patient, but they have absolutely used that goal, early goal by Hazel, to their advantage. It's put El Cerrito on the back foot and really just forced to defend. If you're the Gauchos, you stay back, you defend, and you hope for an opportunity in the counter because you have, Gauchos have two of the best players for a counterattack in all of NCS in Burton and Chin. Gets it forward to Burnett. Last ditch clearance. That has been the story so far. That's in the Gauchos' exceptional season. 5-3 victory. They put five goals up on Campolindo. They could play in the next round. That is remarkable. They fell to Marimonte 3-0, the number one seed in NCS. They finished second to Salesian and the TCAL Stone League. Very good league. Gogenhauer all the way through. Martinez then looked like she was falling over at the purple O, but able to fall on it and corral it. This has been the pressure we've seen all night. Petaluma is not giving any breathing room to the Gauchos, any chance of possession, and any chance to bring the ball forward. It's cruel, mean, and no mercy, but it's what it takes to win NCS playoff games.
Nice play by Barry, who led Petaluma in scoring until she tore her ACL last year in a gut-wrenching injury at Annalee. She's taken a little bit of a lesser role in goal scoring, but still has the potential to be dangerous for Petaluma. Back to Meganum. Hasn't been a lot of action for this Petaluma defense, but they have been very stout so far, as we see a mistake promptly. And now danger with Burton. She just wants to take it herself, run through everyone and get to that. You can see Rocha tried to ride her, and she fires one near the post, but into the side netting. Now Rocha was trying desperately there to grab a hold of Burton, do whatever possible to not get her a good shot on net. What a talented player for the Gauchos. And a nice job by Rocha, but one mistake by this Petaluma defense is so, so dangerous. And Burton has been the head of that. She's, looks like she's talking with the ref. We're going to see a couple substitutions for the Gauchos. She might have wanted a foul there, but they've called this game loosely. Both teams with very deep rosters. As you get to expand your roster for NCS, call up JV players. Petaluma called up a couple JV players of their own to the varsity roster, and Sadie Harrison, the freshman midfielder, and Isabel Van Bieber, the sophomore defender, who both got to see some action in the Trojans' last game against American Canyon, which we were there for Petaluma's VBL clinching victory, a sweet night for them, and also their crazy 1-1 draw against Casa Grande. A Gaucho on goal kept Petaluma undefeated, and in the end was a big part of them taking on the VBL title. We were here. We have that whole game as well up on our YouTube channel. Poor pass. And the Gauchos again with an opportunity here. Gogenhauer battling, called for the foul. And the El Cerrito fans getting something to cheer about. A smattering of fans have made the 45-minute trip northwest from the hamlet outside of Richmond. Lambert, a nice header out. Petaluma's not out of the woods yet. Exceptional play by Rocha, who's been brilliant defensively early. The Gauchos have attacked that left side primarily, hoping for an opening. But the left back, Amanda Rocha, the three-year varsity junior, is not having it. Burton making moves, dancing and prancing. Now getting friends up. That's just not the finishing pass you want if you're El Cerrito. We're still looking for that last pass. The ball pinballs, deflects, and Savannah Sessi will get to touch the ball for the first time tonight. Sometimes that's nice for the goalkeeper just to get your hands on one. But the Petaluma defense is the goal not to have her work anymore tonight. And if they do, there's a good chance they'll have a victory. A late slide tackle there puts Kendra Berry on the ground. And the Trojans get a free kick with Lambert. Under 7 minutes remaining in this first half. It's Petaluma 1, El Cerrito 0. That one will head all the way back. Trojans on a 7-game winning streak. They haven't lost all year. Last year, 15-6-2 overall, 10-2-2 in a very good SCL. They have one-upped it this year with basically their entire team back. And have become a force in Sonoma County. Grabbed the attention of a lot of people. Prep to Prep has them ranked as the 18th best team in all of NCS. And if Petaluma even got to the NCS championship game, they would have a good shot at being asked to the state championships, which will start the last week in February. Into Hazel. Nice passing by Gogenhauer up. Hazel fighting through. Pressure by Gogenhauer. The Gauchos get it out. Oh,
Pressure continues. Frothinger, the junior, just deflected out in another corner for Petaluma, their fourth of this first half. Odalis Davalos, who's the backup goalkeeper, providing some key defense early for the Gauchos. One of only four seniors on El Cerrito. They have eight underclassmen as well. Trojans have a fair amount of young talent as well. Six underclassmen on their team before the two call-ups, so now eight. Ash is cleared away. Trojans will get another opportunity. A lot on the line overall for Petaluma High sports history overall. It's been a long time since the Trojans have sent a team to the semifinals of NCS, not counting a fall season that wasn't full. The boys soccer team did win NCS 3 years ago, but it was in a fall sports when the majority of big schools were playing in the winter already. So if you exclude that, it was the girls softball team 7 years ago, the last Petaluma team to make an NCS semifinals appearance. 7 years later, nearly 7 years later, the girls varsity soccer team in 2019 trying to break that streak. Some teams have gotten close. Is tonight the night? Frothinger knocked out. Under four as Petaluma quickly throws it back into the dangerous Eleanor Burnett, who scored in the closing minutes to get Petaluma that draw against Marin Academy. Nice moves upfield. They get it to Burton. And now here is Davalos. Nodded forward to Burton. Now the Dancing Girls got an opportunity. Good buildup here by El Cerrito. They haven't gotten many chances to do this. They're going to have to make the most of their opportunities. We have a whistle and I think a foul is called, so that's a rough break for El Cerrito. Just cleared out. El Cerrito ranked 333 in the state. Petaluma at 161. We're projected by many to go first in NCS, but the committee decided to see them second. Not a hard schedule to finish without a loss, which is just a remarkable accomplishment, basically unseen. But it is true, the VVAL not the strongest for girls soccer by any stretch of the imagination. Petaluma was really only challenged by Casa Grande. There was no one else in the league that was close to even the level of Petaluma and Casa. They were the only two teams to make NCS. I mentioned Casa is one in an upset, knocked off Maria Carrillo as the 11 seed in Division II girls soccer, and so they're also in a quarterfinal game tonight. Muganum battling with Burr. That's got to be a foul. It will be, and that could be a card, too. Hard foul on Muganum. She disputes the call, but yeah, that was a foul on the senior defender that time, and a dangerous free kick. Not a bad, though, decision by Muganum to get physical there. If Muganum falls or anything like that, you have a girl that has scored 15 goals on the year, one-on-one with Savannah Sessi. So an opportunity here for the Gauchos to send players into the box. They are setting their keeper up. That shows the importance of this. They want everyone up. They don't think they're going to get a lot more chances like this. They still have almost 40 more minutes as the clock has stopped. We're under two left in the half. The Gauchos looking for the equalizer. A loose wall. It's sped towards the goal, and Savannah Sessi makes the save. There is no goalkeeper in net. You can see Martinez racing back. And if the Gauchos, you should just hold on to this ball for a minute. Oh, there was a whistle and a stoppage, which is really advantage Petaluma, or advantage El Cerrito, because Martinez was the player closest to that free kick. As this one set it open, goal, and all the way across. anyone could have gotten on the end of that, they would have easily put it away on the back post. And Frovinger is out of bounds. Now, chaos at Steve Ellison Field on that one. Sessie makes the save, and it was probably the longest run of Catherine Martinez's life, 100 yards sprinting across the field to get back into her net. The ref helped her out a lot. Should have played advantage there, but they stopped for a foul, and she was able to get back in time, and nearly Petaluma still scored. Well, a very risky decision by Coach Piscala for the Gauchos, and it nearly cost them. Rocha to flex. Hazel's provided pressure and energy all night long. Gets it to Gogenhauer. Fires off the post. Rebound. Scores! Absolutely awesome. Hazel has two. It's 2-0 Petaluma. Gogenhauer with one of her electric probing shots tried to get it right under the crossbar. It was just an inch too high, but you always want to follow up your teammate's shots, just like following up a shot in basketball, and Hazel did it perfectly. Easily slotted it away, and it's 2-0 Trojans. Goal scored in the 39th minute, and a huge momentum swing for Petaluma as the Gauchos had battled and were very close to getting to the locker room, only trailing by one, and right in this game, they are in dire straits now.
I miss Ryan so much.
Gauchos clear it away, and for a game that was so even the last time these teams faced off, Petaluma has looked much better tonight. The energy the Trojans have played with, the finishing they have played with, the physicality and the preparation and focus has been absolutely remarkable. And as good as Petaluma's looked all year, this is probably the eighth game I've been at. This is the best I've seen the Trojans all year long, which is remarkable how hard they're working in practice. How hard they're training, how hard they're ready for a moment like this, considering the success on the season. But they are hungry, they want more, and at the end of 40 minutes in the NCS quarterfinals, it's Petaluma 2, El Cerrito 0. Getting ready to start the second half here from Steve Ellison Field, potential history on the line in 40 minutes. But we wanted to alert you of some Petaluma High sports history that has been made down the road at James Logan High School in Union City, where the Petaluma wrestling team was spending the weekend. Connor Pedersen, the senior, last year he lost in overtime in his third place match to miss out on state. This year, his third place match just about an hour ago went to overtime again, but this time Pedersen made it different. He got the first points of overtime, and Connor Pedersen becomes the first Petaluma wrestler, a male Petaluma wrestler to head to the boys' state wrestling championships this decade. History for Petaluma wrestling. Congratulations to Connor Pedersen. An amazing accomplishment for one of the best Petaluma wrestlers to go through Trojan lore this century. El Cerrito's done a lot of talking at halftime, a lot of preparation. We'll see how they try to get Burton more involved, find a way to score, because they will need to. They have the firepower, but Petaluma has neutralized it to a T, and the Trojans have been playing with excellent energy in this one as they try to head to the semifinals of NCS. Don't have any score updates yet for the other two quarterfinals going on at the moment, but before the end of the night, we'll try to let you know who else is moving on to the NCS semifinals. Winner of this one faced Campolindo, who defeated Akalani's 3-1 earlier in Orinda. Ref's final preparations here. They'll switch sides of the field. Silvana Sessi has just had to make one save for Petaluma. The Trojan defense has been dominant. Only a couple minutes of nerves, and it's all been Elena Burton, who is
truly a magician with her feet for El Cerrito. Petaluma can continue to put three girls around her. They're going to be ready. Frothinger.
Hey, offsides is called. I'm a little bit perplexed how you can call offsides so far away. He was about 50 yards away from judging where the offsides is. I don't think that's physically possible with the eyes, but maybe he's got on those Google glasses or something like that. Not sure. Whatever the case, Petaluma will reset and try again. They are not going to stop pushing in this one. There's too much energy on this team. They prepared for a week and a half for this. They want this game too much. Exceptional play by Hazel to stick with it. Back to Elijah Hernandez Ramirez. She sends it wide right. One of the unsung heroes of this Petaluma team and the senior Hernandez Ramirez. Center defensive mid, one of the most vital positions in soccer, but it's not one that gets you in the scorebook a lot, but it's so vital for controlling that play in the middle third of the field and getting it up to your strikers. And Hernandez Ramirez will be dearly missed when she graduates this year, and Petaluma doesn't have that stalwart in the middle of the field to help lead up the offense for Petaluma. Trojans 2, Gauchos nothing. 38 minutes remaining on a very cold night from Ellison Field, the temperature dipping into the low 40s. No rain, though, tonight. After a very rainy week, field has been quite slick, but hasn't affected this game too much on this beautiful artificial turf field, just over a year old. First game ever played on it, in fact, was a Petaluma girls NCS soccer game. Trojans 7-2 first-round victory over Dionza last year. Trojans trying to make more history on it. I would say Crisdale broke the Gauchos' ankles, but I think the Turf Monster did. Who knows who that one was to? Petaluma continuing to push for more. And if you're longtime head coach Antonio Pigicelli for El Cerrito, you have to be scratching your head of a way to get your offense going. That's been so good all year long against good teams. This Trojan defense is on another level right now. Hazel's had an electric night as well. Two goals for her. Gogenhauer, Crisdale, Rocha. Everyone's been a star for Petaluma tonight. This one is fired from way out. The field goal kick is good. Oh, that's the wrong sport. Well, Barry might, if she wasn't a senior, might want to try out for field goal kicking duties for Petaluma football next year, but wrong sport on this Saturday night. If you're the Gauchos, you have to find some way to possess the ball. 44 goals on the year, average over 2 goals per game, coming off a nice 2-goal performance against a good San Rafael team in the first round. Searching for answers tonight. They are seeing purple and white. Gauchos were shut out in the quarterfinals of NCS last year. 2-0 loss to Annalee. Petaluma's looking for 3 here tonight. Burnett made things interesting. Sophomore. And again, it's just cleared. Rinse and repeat right now for the Gauchos. Clearing danger out of the box. How long can they keep it up? Gauchos put 2 goals on Pomole Valley. 2 goals on a good Albany team. 3 goals on Vallejo. We mentioned the 5 against Camp Olindo, their best game of the year. But nothing so far tonight. And there is a recipe. Miramonte, the only team this year to shut out El Cerrito. Petaluma trying to make a second team to do so and send the Gauchos back to El Cerrito with a second straight year of getting eliminated in the quarterfinals. Frothinger. Hernandez Ramirez to a sprinting Rocha, who's
done an excellent job tonight. All the way across, and a nice job by Martinez, the Gaucho keeper, to come on out and take it. It has been an adventure tonight for El Cerrito on the defensive end, and they cannot even get it out of their own end right now. Barry missed kicks. 6 minutes gone in the second half, and Petaluma in command, 2-0. If you missed any of our girls' soccer coverage over the course of the season, and certainly if they win tonight, we will be right back here on Wednesday night for their semifinal match. But if you did, all of our games are on our YouTube channel. Full play-by-play analysis, exclusive interviews, last year's games as well. It's been a lot of fun the last 2 years heading out to Steve Ellison Field, Lucchese Park, to cover one of the most successful and dominant teams in Petaluma sports. Frothiger, Crisdale, spiraling! Martinez got a hand on it. Beautiful buildup. Frothiger has excellent touch to her game, and Crisdale nearly had enough mustard on it to spiral it into the goal. Martinez literally helping El Cerrito hold on by a finger. They cannot afford to allow one more goal. Three goals is essentially insurmountable. Two is reasonable, especially with the talent up top for the Gauchos. Only if they can get it there. Gogenhauer looking for Burnett, but just one defender back to save it. Burnett getting some more action for Petaluma in the second half. Plenty of depth, plenty of legs and warm bodies to go to for head coach Deegan Babala, who's done such an excellent job with his program. Speaking of Burnett, she'll head to the bench, and Anna Herman, the captain for the Trojans, who was getting a rest, will head back on. Lambert to Barry. Interception by the Gauchos. It's been one source, interceptions, counterattacks, and getting it to Byrne that have made things interesting. Trojans have beat up on a lot of bad teams in the VVAL this year, but they have raised their level to higher competition, something that a lot of Petaluma teams have struggled to do the last couple years in NCS, played before this year, playing in the SCL, a weak league, and then heading out even as often higher seeds in NCS was challenging. This one is not going to even have to be touched by Sessi. Wide right. El Cerrito trying, hoping for something to get going. Petaluma already this year undefeated regular season and their first outright league title since 2007. Their last league title was co-champs with Annalie and FCL in 2013, back when Chris Daly was the head coach for Petaluma. But Petaluma has not been past the quarterfinals of NCS this decade. Another interception in the middle of the field, another opportunity for Petaluma to build their offense. It's Frothinger. Three-year varsity junior. Trying to get it to Gogenhauer. Hard shot by Hazel, deflected and never got through. Herman. That was not what she was looking for that time. Late start time to this one, 7 o'clock, and due to the pomp and circumstance of a long PA ceremony where the PA announcer read every single sponsor in mankind, started this game well after 7 o'clock, but the late start has not dampened the crowd as Barry almost spectacularly broke through the defense. This place has only filled up more over the course of the night. They have been loud, they have been vocal, and they have exploded for two Trojan goals so far. Hazel scored 10 minutes in as Martinez couldn't corral her diving shot to the right. And a good buildup, and that really woke up Petaluma, who started off a little bit slowly. They kept the pressure on, and Frances Gogenauer got in her favorite spot. Nailed one off the crossbar. Hazel able to pick up the scraps with just a minute remaining in the first half. And if Petaluma does win this game, that's really the goal to remember, because that really set the tone for Petaluma having a stranglehold on this one. Trojans have controlled it throughout. Have to be about 70-75 possession to the purple and white. And so far, we haven't even seen Burden get involved at all for El Cerrito in the second half. 28 more minutes remaining. Petaluma has fresh legs, too, as this game gets later. They are going to be the fresher team. Haven't played in 10 days, all the way since last Wednesday. Well, it was just 3 days ago that El Cerrito played San Rafael in their NCS first-round victory. Crisdale to Frothinger. Down the wing. Got some space. The Gauchos clear again. Great move by Barry. Rocha. A little bit too far that time, looking for Hazel. Tormented El Cerrito last time, the game-winning goal to beat the Gauchos 3-2 when these teams played in December. She has created even more nightmares tonight for the white and green. Remarkable that there's two white and green teams named Gauchos that Petaluma has faced this year now four times. And so far they haven't lost to either Gaucho team. Hazel firing wide. Well, the Trojans just firing a bunch of shots towards goal, trying to make things interesting, hoping for a mistake from Martinez. She's been stout so far to keep El Cerrito holding on. It's winter sports wind down here at Petaluma. Spring sports getting started up. Petaluma trying to send their first team to the semifinals of NCS in any sport in 6 years. A lot of it often keeps athletes from their spring sports, which can be a conundrum for the spring sports team and a disadvantage, because spring sports games are starting, especially this coming week. We have baseball, softball, lacrosse, a full plethora of games, but girls soccer very much could still be in action. Burton, a chance, fires, Ceci, save. Out of nowhere, El Cerrito with a chance, and Burton had her first touch of the second half. Crisdale just has to clear, but the best chance of the night for El Cerrito. It built up, found way down the wing, and you give it to Renaya Byrne, she can absolutely sprint like no one is watching. 50 yards down the field, she went there. And that time, Petaluma unable to get a body on her, but Ceci just able to tap it over the bar. How about this freshman staying calm in the biggest game of her life? Well, Ceci has been remarkable in net. It's such a mental, have to be such mentally strong as a goalkeeper. And Ceci has never looked nervous. She's does not allow in bad goals at all. If you're going to beat her, it's going to have to be good. Trojans getting it the other way. Hazel running the length of the field here to get a cross in. What an effort by the junior Lauren Hazel, flying all over the field tonight. BVAL Bennett was not enough for these players. They want two hanging up in the gym. approaching the halfway point of the second half. And the Trojans still in front, 2-0. Barry hit hard. It's been a pretty quiet game in terms of fouls. Been good to see they've let them play, and I think the rest have done a nice job tonight. Called the fouls when they've needed to and stayed out of the game otherwise. Lambert fires. Oh, it's loose. Root and Martinez has it. Awfully dangerous there. Lambert has a big leg, and the ref's going to have a discussion with Martinez in net. Martinez just a little bit nervy, unable to handle it, and Hazel and a couple other purple shirts were in the area. Trojans continue to trust the Gaucho keeper, searching for one more. I don't know what this conversation is about, but considering the cold weather here tonight, I don't think the fans are going to be too happy about it. But the game has certainly been full of warmth and excitement on this Saturday night in late February. How much longer does this Trojan season go? It's one game elimination and you're out, but Petaluma could go as far as March 2nd, which would be the championship game for state. State championships start February 26th. And it's just three legs per division. Petaluma would play in Division 3 if they advance to state. They could be playing teams from across Northern California. But that's a long ways to go before that. They need three victories starting tonight to win an NCS pennant. Nice steal, but just unable to do anything with it. Gauchos, the times when they've been aggressive, they have not been able to build on it. That was Binta Mana, the freshman midfielder, one of the underclassmen getting action for the Gauchos. Gauchos haven't looked scared. They've just looked outclassed tonight by Petaluma. There have been some defensive mistakes. They've been cut more down in the second half. Petaluma's goals have been earned. Frothiger finds Crisdale. Gogenhauer! Oh, that's a dangerous spot for the Trojan striker in the box and firing away. And if Gaucho body didn't get on that, these stands would likely be rocking again and Gogenhauer would be getting hugs. Frothinger. Herman trying to bat it down. The adventures continuing on the back end. Gauchos have to find a way to get it out and get it forward just like this. Now they need to get it to Burton. Only two shots on goal in this game for El Cerrito. Sessi's been counting the stars in the sky tonight. Into Burton, Lambert trying to clear. A chance here, but fired over the bar. Gaucho's able to get it up. A better look that time, but it was Mono we just saw fired a little too high. Only two goals for the freshman midfielder. And for a Gaucho team that has three-fourths of their goals from two players, they are the definition of one-dimensional. Reina Burton, 15 goals, averages over a goal per game. And she certainly has shown why tonight, but unable yet to put one in the back of the net. Look like it might have been a foul there. They're going to call advantage. And now they're going to whistle it back as there was no real advantage for El Cerrito, so they're going to get a free kick here. 30 yards out in a dangerous spot. We have reached the 20-minute mark. We are exactly halfway through the second half. Does El Cerrito have a comeback in them? never got through the wall built by the Trojans, and the wall sends it back. Well, walls work in some instances. Gogenhauer and Rocha did there. Stay Gaucho ball, trying to build some possession. Can't score on the counter. That's the only other way. It's possible for a high-scoring Gaucho team. See the El Cerrito fans trying to encourage them on. They've made the long trip, bundled up. They don't want to see El Cerrito go down without a fight, a team that had to have learned from their defeat last year in the quarterfinals. Sessi comes out and snares it away from danger. She and had to come up big in just a couple moments tonight, and she's been excellent. That has been a major difference in the game tonight. A much better goalkeeper for Petaluma, and Silvana Sessi, the freshman, is gonna have Petaluma in good hands for a long time in net. Gogenhauer looking for Crisdale, room down the left side again. Gets around, fires, and just deflected over the bar. Nice hand by Martinez, who's averages 1.5 goals given up per game. Just narrowly avoiding a third given up there. But Crisdale, an excellent move all alone to nearly score. Talented sophomore for Petaluma. Hazel will take the corner. Petaluma's first corner of the second half at 5 in the first. Rocha tried to get a header on it. Came up with air. Crisdale with 5 goals on the year. Well, Petaluma certainly runs a lot of their offense through Hazel and Gogenhauer. They are not a one-dimensional team by any stretch of the imagination. Rocha, Melissa Rocha, before likely being out for the rest of the year, 9 goals for her. Led the team in assists as well, with 9 assists using her speed, but Kendra Berry has 6 goals. Crisdale with 6. It's really spread out. Herman has 5 for Petaluma. They have a lot of options. Frothinger. Hernandez Ramirez. Looking for her second goal, and then Martinez has had some sticky fingers tonight. Second time we've seen her just drop one. When you're Petaluma, which has now hit over 60 goals on the year, 49 assists, they share the ball. When you do something like that, you know it's got to be spread out. It can't be just one person, because some nights someone's not going to have their best night. They're not going to be able to bring it. You have other teammates that can help you, bring you up on the night when the stars aren't at their best. Petaluma's stars have been at their best tonight. But that's the reason Trojans haven't lost all year. They've been consistent, because even when the stars haven't been brightest, there's been other players to pick them up. And they've been focused too. They've known what their goals are. They've known that every game matters. Something last year that they didn't do as well at, they really faded in the back end of the year last year, turned out finishing 3rd in SCL at 10-2-2. Looked a little tired at the end of the year. Were seeded 6th in NCS Division 3, won their first game before losing to Kennedy. Last year they allowed a goal per game, and a lot more goals allowed, and just they looked exhausted by the end of the year. They look worn down. They do not look like that tonight. They look as fresh as can be, in fact. El Cerrito just clearing again, 15 minutes to go. And the Trojans just need to continue to play as they have this whole game. And if they do, they should have a date on Wednesday night right back here at Steve Ellison Field, 7 p.m. against Campo Lindell. Burnett got a foot on that. The Trojans have not faced the Cougars this year or last. Campolindo defeated Annalee 1-0 last year in the NCS championship game to win NCS Division III. They're the defending champions. And so far, they've had no problem in NCS. They had a bye like Petaluma in the first round and then cruise by a good Akilani's team 3-1 earlier tonight. Gauchos trying to get it forward, but no dice. Crisdale looking for Lauren Hazel. She's looking for the hat trick. A little bit too far that time for the junior. Ehrman all the way across the field to Frothinger. In fact, a little bit too far across the field to Frothinger. A rare missed pass. The experience that Petaluma has on this team, and they didn't have last year when they had 14 underclassmen, has made a big difference. You got to work together as one, both defensively and offensively. I think defense more important, but offense to piece things together, piece the puzzle pieces together. And this Trojan team, everyone seems just so intact with each other, each other's moves. They know how they play. They know where they're going to pass before they even do it. And that's so hard for a defense to stop. And defensively, when you know where your teammates are and are working as one wall, one line, it's pretty hard to get around it. That's an excellent steal by Lambert. And that is why she is one of the best defensive players in Sonoma County. The Trojans making Gauchos miss as Crisdale sends a probing pass in. And credit to head coach Deegan Babal for Petaluma's success as well, building their chemistry up and preparing them for a game like this. They have looked so prepared for this game. They knew Burton was how El Cerrito was going to try to run their offense. They'd already seen them before. So here is Burton. Oh, the talented junior. But that pass off the mark. And the defense has looked totally ready to stop El Cerrito, and they very much looked prepared offensively, and they've known for a week and a half that this was likely who they were going to face, likely who they should prepare for. And the familiarity, I think, absolutely helped the second time around as Petaluma had one of their toughest games of the year. They haven't had a lot against El Cerrito, probably one of their three or four toughest games of the season. What a move by Crisdale. Up over the head, hopping through. She's fouled, and there's no call. Now the ref is getting ready to go home. The Trojans could be out here all night fighting, though. This is not who you want, though, with the ball at her feet. Burton trying to get around Rocha. Lambert's coming over to help. There's a wide open goal. What a spectacular offsides. Wow. The El Cerrito fans did not even hear it. They were celebrating, and only now is it settling in. Offsides is the call. We did not get a good look at that at all. That was exceptional job from Burton. Three defenders around her. Lambert came well off her mark to try to stop her, as has been the strategy for Petaluma. And it left a Gaucho totally uncontested, but they got lucky. The offsides able to hold their line. Man, if that Gaucho was just a little bit farther back, would have been able to. An exceptional header put in the corner of the net as well. Frothinger. Fired. Well, high. Gogenauer's had a couple good looks, but not able to connect just yet. 10 minutes remaining. Still stays Gaucho ball. Hit the 10-minute mark. The Gauchos have made a couple adjustments in the second half. They've still stuck back on the defense, but they haven't forced it through Burton, and that has helped the Gauchos get some opportunities. Sessie's come up big, the offsides bailout, and they're still looking for two. It's still definitely not over till it's over. We saw that last night here at Steve Allison Field in the season opener for the lacrosse team. Blew a 3-goal lead in the last 6 minutes. The Gauchos have the firepower, they have the experience, and they have wanted this game, no doubt about it. Hernandez Ramirez, lots of room and lots of speed for the senior. Burnett, a little too short for Hazel. Back to Herman. Gogenhauer, this team's such in sync right now. Hard play there. They're just going to head out. Gaucho ball. If you're El Cerrito, you cannot sit back any longer. You got to start getting urgent. Your season is on the line. Such a great year. 7th in NCS, 12-4-3 overall. 9-0-3 in an exceptional TCAL Stone League. All that they have to leave out on the field in the next 8 minutes. This defense continuing to provide pressure up top. Even the strikers can play defense for Petaluma. And it heads out. Sloppiness has been the one thing you'd really want back if you're Antonio Pagala and this El Cerrito squad. That's a foul on Herman. And a conversation with the co-captain for Petaluma. Co-captains along with Frothinger and Gogenhauer. Herman. Oh, had Burnett, just missed her. This defense for El Cerrito was held on in the second half, and it has made that late goal with a minute left stand up all the more. El Cerrito trying to get possession. Hernandez Ramirez sends it in all the way. Keeper gets it. Gaucho's forward looking for their star striker, but unable to again. 3 minutes left, time running out on El Cerrito comeback. Petaluma defense has been lethal and clinical in this second half and just been able to be in control. Out of bounds, unable to keep it in. And you can see it starting to settle in for the Gauchos. They are in trouble now. Crisdale. Petaluma is starting to get more patient here and can't blame them. Knock it back to your defenders and start to wind the clock at this point. But they've remained aggressive for the majority of the second half. Been smart to do so. Lambert, exceptional defensive play. She has been on an island tonight, and she has made play after play. Crisdale. Forward, Barry. Druden still looking for a third one. They've been close a couple times. Hold on to it. Hernandez Ramirez. So we are about to reach the 2-minute mark. Clock will go off in the stadium, And however much time is left in this quarterfinal will be up to the ref's discretion. Having a couple camera adventures in these last couple minutes here, but hasn't been much of an adventure for Petaluma. They're cruising now to victory under two. And they're going to get a corner here, try to add a third. And El Cerrito headed quietly into the night. History tonight for Petaluma girls soccer. They're going to head to the semifinals for the first time this decade. First Petaluma team, not counting that boys soccer team that won NCS, to head to the NCS semifinals in 6 years. Softball team the last time, as that one comes all the way through. And they will face Camp Olindo for a spot in the NCS championship game. Froth and Gurr scores! Absolutely spectacular from Frothinger, the cherry on top for the junior. She always told me she never scored when I was here, and now she has, absolutely spectacularly as well. Frothinger could have not placed that one better, and she'll send the Trojan fans delighted into the night, 3-0. As in the 79th minute, Frothinger adds to the lead from well out, but she is one of the most talented players on this Petaluma team, and the junior just showed you why. What a way to finish the night. And there should be mere seconds remaining before the final whistle. The Trojans trying to get a shutout would be their 11th shutout of the season. Burton all the way across. Frothinger will get it forward. What a night for this Petaluma defense. How good have they been? Forward, Harmon. And nice job by Harmon just to pull back. That's good sportsmanship at this point. No need to rub it in. Only a need to get to Wednesday night. Wednesday night, 7 o'clock, right here at Steve Ellison Field. Number 2 versus number 3, Petaluma versus Camp Olindo. The Cougars will certainly be quite a challenge for the Trojans, but the way they played tonight, they're all for it. It was kind of a half-hearted go at it from Barry. She didn't want to be mean, but you also can't take up a wide-open opportunity. Other history tonight, Connor Pedersen becomes the first Petaluma boys wrestler to head to state this decade. The girls soccer team will add to a very exciting night in Petaluma lore. An exceptional season for the wrestling team, and Pedersen is going to be able to continue it next Thursday at Bakersfield in the Rabobank Arena. We'll have a full report Tuesday morning on our Trojan Live show of the weekend in Petaluma sports, and it's turning out to a very good President's Weekend for purple and white fans. That is it! For the first time this decade, Petaluma girls soccer is headed to the semifinals of NCS. One down, two to go to an NCS pennant. The Trojans clinical, dominant, ready, and they absolutely dominated Gauchos team that would challenge them last time out. Final score here from Steve Ellison Field, Petaluma 3, El Cerrito 0.
We are here with the girl of the hour, Lauren. It's your birthday, and you scored 2 goals in the first half to put you guys up 2-0. What did this night mean for you?
I think that we all just wanted it so much, and we worked together, and I'm so happy that we got the result that we did.
You guys look so prepared and ready. What was the team's mindset and strategy going into this game, especially because you played El Cerrito before?
I think that we were practicing against how they were playing and just working off of the ethics that we knew they had. So, I don't know, we just put the pieces together and figured out how to win this game.
You're the leading goal scorer on this team, 2 goals tonight. What do you see out on the field that makes you so successful goal scoring wise?
Honestly, I think that my team helps me a lot. I couldn't do it without them and without the support that they give me, and you know, it's a team sport, so without them I couldn't have done it.
You guys head to the semis, it only gets harder from here. What's your guys' focus going up against Campbell Lindo in the next round?
I think we're just going to try to keep playing how we are and continue to improve, and hopefully that'll give us the result.
Thank you so much, Lauren. Congratulations and happy birthday. We are here with Sarah Muganum after Petaluma wins the NCS quarterfinal game 3-0. Defender, you guys were dominant defensively tonight. Why are you able to be so successful?
We all played really nicely together, and we were very strong with the fact that we needed to push up. They have a really fast center forward, number two, that we knew going into the game, so we were playing strategically the whole time.
This is your guys' third NCS quarterfinal in a row. As a senior now, what did you guys learn from those first two losses in quarterfinals to win tonight?
I think it's to keep the energy up the entire game. I think the past 2 years, energy really dropped in like the last 10 to 15 minutes. And we just need to push through because we have the capability to go far this year.
Now you guys head to the semifinals. What does this run mean for you as a senior? And how far do you think this team can go?
So far, it means so much. And this team just has the best bond. And we're all just really great friends. And we want to do this for Petaluma and for ourselves as well.
Thank you so much, Sarah. Congratulations on the great game. We've got a special exclusive fan interview here with Jack Sullivan, who's out at you're almost out at every girls soccer game, aren't you?
Oh yeah, I'm a huge fan of the sport. You know, been following it since about second grade. It's a pretty intense game, not gonna lie.
Yeah, this team looked totally dominant. Was this the best you've seen the girls soccer team all year? And how do you think they were so successful tonight?
You know, they had some pretty good runs, but honestly, they've been better. You know, they started out a little slow, but, you know, end of the first half, really picked it up, you know. So I think they ended the game on a high note, but it could have been better to start.
What are the strengths of this team? They played El Cerrito previously. It was super close. This time they blew them out of the water.
I think they have a lot of offensive firepower, which is pretty crazy, you know. But one area, and they always have, like, fast players, too, which is pretty insane. So go Trojans.
That's your soccer expert, Jack Sullivan. A game here tonight from Steve Ellison Field as Petaluma routes El Cerrito 3-0 the final. These teams were so close, so evenly matched last time, but Petaluma had a week and a half to prepare. Head coach Deegan Vivola devised up a master plan, and with 9 seniors and nearly the whole team returning from previous NCS defeats in this stage, this team was ready for revenge and ready for dominance, and that's what they did nearly the whole night in complete control. Lauren Hazel had the early goal. That second goal, huge for momentum, and Petaluma really just controlled that second half the whole way along, added a late one with Frothinger's spectacular goal. And the defense for Petaluma, totally dominant. Silvana Sessi, what a performance she had. It all led up to dominance, and Petaluma heads to the NCS semifinals for the first time this decade. A fantastic accomplishment, but as we've said, for everything this team has accomplished so far this year, they are by no means done. A lot of season left for Petaluma. It will continue next Wednesday here, Steve Ellison Field at 7 p.m. We will be back out here with coverage of that NCS semifinal game as they take on the defending NCS champion, Campo Lindo Cougars. Don't miss that on our YouTube channel. For everyone here at Trojan Live, I'm Griffin Epstein. The final score from Steve Ellison Field, Petaluma 3, El Cerrito 0. Good night, everyone.